Welcome back to Escapement and Watch. Falling Titan here. Thanks to Kavar Jewelers for lending this into the channel. And if you want to buy this Aquis, email me in the description below and I'll give you a discount code. Introducing the ORIS AQUIS Cherry Red. Look at that beautiful sunray dial. That's what ORIS is calling it. And this watch is a little bit special because it proves companies are listening to the enthusiasts. We like to believe that we are the majority, but in actuality, we are the minority. And the red bar enthusiasts across the world have been speaking to ORIS and requesting a red dialed AQUIS, and ORIS did deliver. They brought the vision to life, and hopefully the red bar members are excited. I think it looks beautiful. ORIS is calling it cherry red sunray dial, and definitely something different and interesting to look at. Big fan of it. I do really appreciate that color. Look at that. So I love how it changes from black to red on the edges. Almost a fume dial effect. Hopefully the camera is picking it up. What a stunner. Now, we've done the AQUIS many times on the channel, but it does have the traditional kettle-shaped case, iconic to ORIS, integrated bracelet, proprietary lugs, beautiful casework, brushing, high polish on the top, continues down on the bracelet. Screw-down crown, signed ORIS. If you damage your crown guards, you can replace them with that special screwdriver. Looks awesome. Now, the movement. This one has the ORIS 733 caliber based on the Solita SW200. 28.8 VPH, a nice smooth sweep, 38 hours of power reserve, 26 joules, hack hand wind automatic. Okay, and the measurements that I got are 41.3 in diameter, 12.6 in thickness. That is including that double dome sapphire crystal with anti-reflective coating on the inside only. And the lug to lug that I got, 48 even. Okay, and that's including the integrated bracelet lugs. So I measured it right there. Okay, guys. Now the bracelet is a beauty. Look at that. Look at this. Everything is solid. Everything is well machined and milled and polished and smooth and buttery. I'm a big fan of ORIS's bracelets. They always feel a little bit above everyone else's. They do remind me of the Submariner's oysters in feel, in quality, and that's a huge compliment. Now, this one does have a dive extension right there, and we have three micro adjusts. Milled clasp, of course, and is screwed links right there, if you can see them. So excellent, fantastic bracelet. You're never going to take it off this bracelet, so don't worry about the proprietary integrated lugs. I forgot to mention the display case back with the sapphire showing off that red rotor. Now, the bezel insert is stainless steel relief system, the only relief bezel on the 41 AQUIS, and it is a nice look. It reminds me of the Yachtmaster, but this is steel and the Yachtmaster is ceramic, I believe. And there is a loom pip at 12. The action, typical ORIS. Really, there is no back play, just settling. Nice tactile feel. These teeth are a little bit sharp on this bezel. I can feel it even with my gloves. Everything lines up, fantastic. What do you guys think? I wish it was a black ceramic insert or black steel. I think black and red, dark cherry look, I think it just goes. And I feel like this silver steel insert will shrink the visual look on the wrist. We're gonna check it out later on my wrist and find out. Now, the dial and hands, we already talked about that beautiful Sunray Cherry Dial, white text of ORIS AQUIS 300 meter, and the black date window. It really pops, the white and the white loomed hour indices. Everything pops on that red cherry, so it looks fantastic. Legibility, excellent. And I love those robotic fingers, four hands. The hour hand looks like a thumb of a robot, and the minute hand looks like maybe a middle finger of a robot. And of course, the indices look like fingernails of a robot. Excellent. I love the futuristic look of the hands and the indices. Beautifully done. Now the price. This one is not limited. I believe it's in regular production now. I don't know for how long, but it's $2,300 USD. All right. So entry luxury level, and you're getting a high quality Swiss made watch. Let's compare it with the SKX. Okay, here it is next to my SKX. SKX is 42 millimeters and this one 41.5. So look at that. The AQUIS does look a lot smaller, not a little bit smaller. That is that integrated bracelet look. That's what it does. Just shrinks the watch. And I think that bezel insert is doubling down on that effect, making it look even smaller. Wow. Yeah, you know what? Maybe I would need a 43 AQUIS. Okay, let's check it out on my wrist. Okay, here it is on my 6.5 inch wrist. What do you guys think? I think it wears almost perfect. One with the wrist at 12.6 in thickness. Beautiful taper on that bracelet. And yeah, it sits really nicely. I'm looking around the camera, not in the viewfinder anymore, and yep. In real life, it really does look like it wears perfect. Maybe a touch small for my wrist, for my preferences. I don't know, maybe I like the 43 now after putting this one on. I do think it's that bezel shrinking it even more because my eyes are just looking at the red. Gotta try on one with the black bezel for sure. Apparently the 41.5 is rare in the ORIS line. Something about like 10% of the production. I'm not sure if that's true. I read it somewhere, I forgot. So definitely not a common size for the AQUIS. Let's check out the weight. Wow, 154. That is like a perfect weight for me. I love it, and that's with all the links. So this is a great weight. I'm gonna get to 51 and let's hit it. Boom. There you can hear that medium beat, 28.8, and has that great sweep. Wow, look at that powerful amplitude, 319. We got 9 seconds a day. We're gonna ignore the first number as usual. Let the time grapher get its bearings and look at this, 0.00. And 0.3 milliseconds in beat air. Now 0.2 milliseconds in beat air, but we're staying at 0 seconds a day with our rate. So excellent results here. Definitely ORIS regulating this one, but look at the snowflakes. It could be case interference because the AQUIS does have a powerfully thick case, very beefy, or it could be my voice from the microphone picking it up. But I've talked before in many of these videos and we usually don't get this many flakes, but yeah, wow. All right, so it's just about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 snowflakes. It's not that bad. Maybe I misread it. The beat error was tricking me. Yeah, I misread it, but look at that. You can't complain. Oh man, the amplitude is so powerful. 320 and consistent zero. Unbelievable. Okay, just went to -4. Let's give it a second. Will it correct? Yep, it's correcting, okay? -1. Okay, so a little bit of a hiccup there, but the rate is continuing. -1, -1. And +1. All right, so you know what guys, this is a fantastic movement, and yeah, whoever buys this one, I think you will be happy. Yeah, good job ORIS. 0 seconds a day, just went back, nice. Okay, there is the loom, and I do have a nightlight on in the background. As you can see it right there, and it is powering through, excellent. Love that Swiss Superluminova. The AQUIS doesn't disappoint with its loom. Very nice. And if you want to see it next to the SKX, just for a frame of reference, this is the SKX. There you go. The SKX looking a little bit brighter, but when I look around the viewfinder, they look the same. Just green has that little bit brighter look to the eye. Okay, here she is in the half lighting, and as you can tell, that dial does turn into a blood red to black depending on that lighting. And once it hits that light, very nice, that cherry sunray effect comes through. So a beautiful looking dial, interesting look for sure. But this watch is hope for the future, that big brands will make more enthusiast focused pieces. And that's exciting, and I'm a big fan of that. And if you like this video, please like, share, and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.